I feel subconscious calling myself a climber. To be like the kind of climber that everybody expects you to be requires a lot of money and free time and ability to just live on the road.
Yes!
Ultimately, it's detrimental to the sport of climbing if we have such a high bar for what makes you a climber. When I'm on the wall and I have to only think about my next move, that's when I feel like a climber. Living in Boston, there is a term for people who live here called massholes.
There is like a coldness to the city in terms of like out on the street, you're not gonna get a whole lot of smiles from people.
And then you make a trip to the climbing gym and it's bright, it's light, there are colors everywhere. Everybody says hello to you when you walk in.
It is a place where you can just strike up a conversation with a stranger. And I think there's also something special about the people you meet climbing because you have to kind of be vulnerable to another person pretty quickly.
You are so good. I love it. It's fun.
You got it, LaVantia.
Climbing is a sport that can still feel largely inaccessible to a lot of people.
I lived in Florida and like there is just no access to outdoors. Like if people were going climbing, they were getting on planes and they were going somewhere for like this long extended trip, and that just wasn't possible at the time for me.
That's a really good job.
There's a lot of privilege to being able to climb outside. And I think that's really important to recognize. And especially as a person of color, like I really can't divorce what I look like and my experience. Like not everyone feels safe outside, especially if you don't have a history of feeling welcomed. So I think it's really important to unpack that history and that privilege of why not everyone feels comfortable in going outside.
The text would be,
we'd come into the gym and every time she'd be like, going up. Like, now it's gonna be in my head all day again.
Like, going on a climbing trip with a few people to a place like Moab, it's an awesome kind of intimacy challenge, both physically and socially. But you're all participating in this adventure together.
You almost become like an armchair geologist. Like, oh, you know, when you do quartzite, like, I'm gonna climb it like this versus limestone versus granite. Like, and then you start to be like all trying to read it.
Why did I do this?
So like sandstone for me, I'd never climbed it. It's a very different experience. So sometimes that's really hard to train for in a gym.
You okay?
It's your butt?
Yeah.
Okay.
That didn't look fun.
No.
Shit. Yeah, Lauren.
You and Lauren.
I think that there is this kind of contagious aspect of climbing where people who climb are telling their friends about climbing and are getting their friends into climbing.
It means that more people are climbing now, and it means that the limited climbing areas are now more populated, and the people who have been climbing for forever are a little bit annoyed that their favorite routes are being crowded out. while I totally get that, ultimately, more people participating in healthful activities is a greater good. I think that is far more important than like owning a mountain or a route or a space outside, because it is a space for everybody.
I think that there are definitely different definitions of climber for different people.
At the end of the day, I think it's what you want. And like ultimately, I don't think anyone should cast an aspersion for what brings someone joy.